Greetings, seekers after enlightenment. Yes, it's the Irish fella. Now, those few of you who are subscribers know that I am neither average or conventional. I speak about many things that occupy the mind of someone who is embracing the dual concepts of being a Renaissance man and pushing towards a personal transhuman awakening. And I have to admit, I get frustrated at times because it seems that the people that are out there, crying about women as a shorthand, are getting all the action. But I have to admit that female nature is universal and it is unchanged. And we must still expose female nature for those who have not come to the red pill yet. And that's why I'm here. I would like to discuss female manipulation. Now, due to my tradcon upbringing and chivalric impulses, my ex-wife took advantage of those characteristics. She was great at pretending to be a submissive tradcon wife in public. In private, it was a whole nother story, but we don't need to get into that. I only say that to say that it took me a while to deprogram myself. Now, I still have those chivalric impulses I used to cherish, but their application has been snuffed out. It is not worth the time to do something like that for someone who does not appreciate you. And it was not an easy journey for me to get where I am now. But I underwent a crisis recently, as you have seen in a recent video I did called Black Pill Blues. And I wanted to highlight that for a moment because there was an attempt to manipulate me again, but it did not work. Here I am at what used to be my place of power. Now, the power is still here, but the power is within me. And now, I'm in a hurry to get up the hill if I'm in town, just like I used to, but I'm in a hurry to get to my RV. Because it is, as the leftists say, my safe space. That, be honest, brutal honesty is what I do. I'm just telling it as it is. So, there used to be a hippie chick that lived up here named Michelle. In fact, if you look back in my playlist, you can see the memorial I did for her. Now, there is another woman here who is the stepmom for a 13-year-old girl. And that's important, you know. She needs a mother figure. But I was introduced to her, and we ended up forming a really intense spiritual bond. And she started calling me her adopted brother, and I called her my adopted sister. There are times when we would make a 5-hour road trip for weed purchases and not even say a dozen words to each other because we were that happy just to be in the other person's presence. But due to the events that happened a while back, it literally broke my heart. The persona that was her brother is dead. And I backed off and I've gone into what I call roommate mode. And it's actually one of the things that made monk mode easier for me because I've been doing this for years. People have described me as the perfect roommate. And when I worked out of town, I was lucky enough to be with relatives or church friends. And I made an effort to be as inobtrusive as possible. Cook my own food. Stay in my room or stay out of the house. Stay out of trouble. Because it's like, hey, I'm lucky that I have this outlet to be able to work and come back to someplace warm and safe. So I'm not going to mess it up. But that's what I'm doing here. But of course, women don't look at it that way. According to her, this is just some sort of act that I'm doing just to piss her off. So yesterday, I'm on the back porch. It's one of the few places where I can get the sporadic internet that operates here. And presently, there's like 8 people in the house on phone, so the internet is spotty at best. So she's there talking shit. I'm hearing, but I'm not responding because I don't really have anything to say. Finally, I said, okay, I'm going to go through this one more time. And I started going through the events of the last day before my semi-psychotic break. And I start going through this, and all of a sudden she says, I didn't say that. And Red Pill Wisdom allowed me to respond instantly. And I told her, well, if you think I'm lying, then there's no need to continue this conversation. I turned around and instantly left. And it shows how women don't think long term. Not 2 minutes before, her and her daughter, who's here with her family, were talking about how they manipulate their husbands with their husband sitting right there next to him. You know, sometimes looking like you're not paying attention, but you are, is a great tool for you to get these little hooks. So you could almost see the wheels turning in her mind. It's like, oh yeah, you know, I can manipulate my man whenever I want. Watch me do it to this fool. Wrong, simple bitch. See, Red Pill Wisdom allowed me to short circuit right through all that and say, no, it ain't happening. And you know the manufactured crisis we're going through is going to make women more and more desperate. On a scale of 1 to 10, they're going to turn their chameleon skill up to 11. I have to admit, when I watched Mike the MGTOW Man's video about the crying woman who suddenly realized that now without fake up, she has less attractiveness, and applying the fake up and manipulating men was the only skill she had. And she's like, literally, yeah, men will be looking for the women who can catch a chicken, pluck it, and cook it for them, that can catch and gut a fish, that can shoot and gut a deer. Now, be careful. Country girls can be just as deceitful as city girls. So don't think that because these women have been isolated for so long, and now they've suddenly changed their tune, and they're going to be submissive or even engage in a partnership. Because we know feminism has brainwashed women into not going for equality or an egalitarian relationship. What they want is supremacy and male enslavement. Well, bitch, that ain't happening with me. So, brothers, I'm done babbling for now. I just wanted to jump out here and share that with you, that to show you, even during this crisis, women are proving that they are the epitome of can't understand normal thinkers. Do not be fooled by the actions of women now or in the future. The laws have not changed. You may think you found that unicorn that was hiding in the woods, but she will Duluth model your ass in a New York minute. You're in jail, and all the preps that you worked so hard to get are now hers, which will be shared with Chad and Tyrone. So, sorry, Missy. I know the game. I know your tricks, and I refuse to play. Brothers, remember, you have already made a choice to walk away if you have taken the red pill. Do not fall into that trap that is being laid for you even as we speak. MGTOW for life, monk for life.